This is Dr. Jabir Ali. I work here as director into the Center for Knowledge Management, ICT and Mass Media. I'm going to discuss a very important issue here on supply chain management in agriculture. The agenda for this session is to understand the basic concept first and the benefits related to it. Then to understand how value chain and supply chain works together, what are different components in this and how this works in field of agriculture. Also to look at how the process of supply chain management can be applied in the field of agriculture, and then to find out the major challenges which is being faced in agriculture supply chain system. The first point, if you look at here, is how to really differentiate between the concept of value chain and supply chain. When we talk about value chain, it actually comprises two components into it. One is how the structure of the chain works and how different stakeholders into this interact. The next part is the economic analysis of the value chain, how each and every stakeholder in this is actually adding value, and that's why we consider them, we call them productive agent. How each and every productive agent look or use factors of production and then produce something. And we try to find out how this value addition happens for each and every stakeholder and how margins are being created. So in totality, the value chain talks about how much value has been created or added by each and every stakeholder in the value chain, starting from the farm gate to the consumer gate. When we talk about supply chain management, it is a higher version of value chain, which is not only talking about economic analysis of it, but it talks about how the collaboration and relationship among each stakeholders in the value chain works, how they are collaborated in terms of the flow of goods and services, flow of revenue, and also flow of information which happens in both the directions. So in nutshell, supply chain try to integrate each and every activity of agriculture, starting from the crop planning to the post-harvest management and also to the distribution of agricultural produce. So if you look at here the structure of supply chain, it comprises with the supplier to the consumer, and you can find out different kind of flows in this. The flow may be related to material flow, information flow, finance flow and commercial flow. We can apply this concept in agriculture by looking at how input comes into this, how that is being cultivated, a crop has been cultivated, how that is being post-harvested, then distributed, retailed and went to the consumer gate, and how all the interaction happens, that is actually talks about the structure of the supply chain. Maybe in broad sense for agriculture, we can divide the whole network into three major parts. One is input sector, and that is the production agriculture, and third one is the processing sector or distribution. So these three components together makes the supply chain network for agriculture. The components, if you talk about in the supply chain, there can be related to the input, that what I said, farm, market, processing, distribution and consumer. And there can be different kind of solution when we talk about supply chain management in terms of input, how input management can take place. In case of farm, how contract farming can help adding value at the farm gate. At the market, how we can provide different kind of logistic services so that we can have efficient and effective market system, and so on. If you look at the stages in the supply chain management, we start with the plan, we go for analyzing, we go for developing the system, integrating each and every stakeholder, delivering it, and then return. Return means here that we call return logistics or reverse logistics. Even again we come back to the same to take the feedback and again add value. So this is a very good system of integrating each and every stakeholder in the chain. In terms of performance indicators, normally as we go and do this for industry, we can also go for setting KPIs for supply chain management in agriculture, which can be divided into three major components: input performance indicators, it can be process or cultivation performance indicators, it can be output performance indicators. And we can take some benchmark, and deviation from the benchmark and the actual gives a kind of differences which can be called as deviation from the benchmark, means we are not performing best. So if you really want to measure the performance for each and every stakeholder in the chain, we can follow two views. One is push and pull view, another is cycle view. So maybe we can look at here, this can be more of cycle view, means input performance, how the input sector works, how we get the seed, fertilizer and other input into the production system, whether that is coming on time or not, whether this is costly or whatever. Means we can set the parameters, KPIs, that we call key performance indicator, and accordingly measure the performance for each and every layer of the chain or each and every cycle of the chain. If you talk about the major challenges faced in supply chain management, we can look at which can also be a very good insight in terms of what innovation we need in terms of improving the efficiency and effectiveness in the agricultural value chain or supply chain. We need to first talk about production agriculture, how a crop is being produced at the farm gate and how each and every producer are so sensitive in terms of producing only grade A material. How the post-harvest management happens, how the transportation system for agriculture is being developed and designed, what kind of storage and warehousing, cold storage, cold chain are being done, how the packaging is being done, and then ultimately distribution and retailing. If you look at here, the key issues which happens here, if we talk about the kind of logistics innovation we need, even in terms of transportation, we always use open transport when we load the material, and also even 4-5 people sitting on the top to protect it rather than destroy it. Warehousing, again, most of the warehouses are open in nature, you know, and we are not able to protect them from the rainfall or, you know, moisture or even other kind of pest attack and, you know, insect attack. But if you talk about international standards, most of the vehicles in international freight system is closed vehicle, and maybe we can go for adopting these kind of high level of technological intervention in terms of improving the transportation system in case of agriculture transport. In terms of storage, we can go for silos, and that is a very good model which has been even introduced in India. Number of state has already gone for public-private partnership in improving the silos and or introducing the silos in Indian agriculture system. One of the case is very important in Moga district. FCI and Adani group has tried to create a silo under public-private partnership to have a modern storage system, to create a modern storage system for grains in India. And that's really one of the state-of-art facility which has been created by FCI and Adani. Similar kind of intervention can be done to improve the efficiency of storage in India too, for other cases. In terms of packaging and distribution, again we are going for very open kind of packaging. We pack with the, you know, by using the raw materials, which is basically the wastage of the crop, and we put, like here you can see in the picture, the mango has been stored like this, which also creates a lot of problem in terms of the quality deterioration and the losses. Maybe we need to improve the packaging system. In terms of distribution, again our retail system is very much, you know, open in nature. We go into fresh, that is good, but still we have a lot of opportunity to improve the efficiency and through a good distribution network. And in summary, if you look at here, for having a very good system in agriculture, operations management in agriculture is the need of hour for enhancing efficiency and effectiveness. If you really want to have the value chain and supply chain working better, we need to really set the goal in terms of, for each and every stakeholder, in terms of KPIs to be looked at, and try to map maybe the wastage level at each and every level, value addition into it, and the quality. And that's why it's high time to identify the major challenges into agriculture value chain and supply chain, and try to provide some kind of solutions for each and every stakeholder, so that we can have better delivery of the product which is being produced by using lot of resources at the farm gate to the consumer gate of good quality. And this will really help us in terms of having increase of farmers' income in a big way, because if we have very good supply chain system, we can reduce the post-harvest losses at the farm gate or other stages in a very significant manner, which can add value to the farmer and also to other stakeholders. Thank you very much.